let's stay with our feet a little bit wider than shoulder width apart. Go ahead and begin with knocking at the gates of life. So just turning from the center. Arms are relaxed and loose. Movement begins from the lower dantian, from the pelvis. The arms are relaxed and loose, swinging free. Palm of the hand hitting right above the hips and the quads. And on the back side, the back of the hand is striking against the upper part of the glutes. And finding where your breath begins to sync up with the rhythm of the movement. Maybe breathing in at one side and out to the other. Or breathing in from one side to the next and then breathing out back where you started. Finding where the breath and the movement sync up, because in Qigong, the breath becomes the vehicle to carry your intent. Begin to slow down the movement of the monkey mind to invite into stillness. Stillness within movement. Let's go ahead and move up the hands a little bit to the lower abdomen. Right about it where your belt line would be if you were wearing a pair of pants. And as you sync up the movement with the breath, begin to see how the movement and the breath together bring oxygen down into these places in our body, in our hips, our glutes, our lower abdomen that can often become very stagnant. Let's go ahead and move up to the mid part of the abdomen, parallel with the belly button, the back of the hand starting to come up into the small of the back. Move up to the upper abdomen, right beneath the sternum. The back hand is right about where the kidneys are. Sometimes I like to visualize myself as a whirling dervish, or as a, even more playful, as a blender, mixing up, churning all of the ingredients and the stagnation, mixing into the beginning of the alchemy. Drawing up the white fire within. Let's come up to where the chest and the shoulders come together, that connective tissue, crossroads of so many of the body's meridians. Up the lungs. And let's come up to the tips of the shoulders now. Back of the hands still striking about where the kidneys are. Knocking at the gates of life. Who is knocking? Will you let them in? And slowly come back to center. Hands are loose and heavy down to the ground. Weeping willow by the pond. Fingertips resting like the willow's branches on the earth. Remember that figure eight, so as we breathe in off into one side, it's like the breath lifting the branches in the breeze. As we exhale, coming back to center, breathing in and over to the other side.
relax, slow, whatever the flow. Imagine being a willow in the middle of summer, blowing on a summer breeze. Tips of the branches leaving little ripples across the surface of the pond. Coming back to center, let's bring our fingers over to the long bone points and sort of the arches of the feet. We're going to start the knocking up the inside of the ankles, the calves, the knees, the quads,
up the abdomen to the heart, down along the inside of the right arm, along the back, back across the heart. Out along the inside of the left. And the neck, the jaw, the temples, the crown, crown behind the ears, top of the head. And back down the back of the head, down the neck, shoulders rolling around behind and going down the spine, down the glutes and the hamstrings. Calves, heels, and now we're gonna just smooth, drawing up the energy, almost like we have like small sponges in our hands, drawing that sweet golden energy from the earth up and across the chest, the heart, out across the arms, bathing, cleansing, preparing. Up the face, washing the face, the top of the crown, back of the head, back of the neck. Down the back, down the hamstrings and the calves. Now this time, same thing, except now we're just gonna float, drifting the energy on the in the biofield. And I just smooth out the energy up into the heart, from earth to heart, heart to the arms. Up and across the face, top of the crown, down through the hollow empty legs, and then bringing the hands to rest back into center, squatting down if you can a little bit into your legs, into your quads, reaching down into the earth, almost as if you were grabbing a golden bar of energy, a little bit of the electromagnetism of the earth, imagining that gold moving through your hand like living liquid river of gold. And we lift, pulling, drawing, allowing the legs to take the weight, almost as if we're lifting a bar. And then we roll at the heart, lifting up, pressing that golden energy up into the heavens. And then we create a giant arc, creating a giant sphere, bending that river of golden energy into a giant circle. Smoothing out the edges, living, turning, churning. The right arm remains above, the left arm sweeping down underneath the hold. Feeling the weight of your body pressed against your feet, feeling the strength of the base that you create. And then as we breathe in, we're just gonna begin to turn, turning the ball. Breathing in, breathing out, finding where your breath sinks with the movement. And as you do so, slowly compacting that ball until it gets smaller and smaller. And allowing the center of the hands, the lagong points, to engage almost as if there was a golden rod connecting between them until the ball is about the size of a watermelon. Then we're going to lift it out to the heart. Holding that melon, holding that energy. Again, find the connection between the center of the palms of the hands. Find the magnetism between the hands. And then let's draw that into the heart, bathing, saturating the upper torso, the heart, the lungs. And then we draw that energy all the way through the body, almost as if we were sewing. And then we bring those threads of energy back together by the lower dantian. holding, feeling the magnetism. And then let's draw the energy in towards the lower dantian. And all the way through, once again, as if we're threading needle and thread all the way through the body, bringing the arms back together at the heart and lifting up so it's about at a 45 degree angle above the front of the crown of the third eye. The upper dantian. And then let's wash that energy in and through. This time just down to the central column. And we hold, finding that giant beach ball. Just holding for a moment. And as you're holding, I'm going to invite you to again imagine those roots going down from the bottoms of your feet into the earth. Through cool, moist soil, through flowing underground water, through crystal chambers, down to the core of the earth. So that as we breathe in, drawing the energy from the core of the earth, up through roots, through hollow, empty body. Overflowing at the arms, filling the reservoir between the arms and the lower dantian. And overflowing still, almost as if antlers or branches, which will extend through the top of the crown, intertwining with the branches of the forest, and reaching further still, intertwining, touching the stars, the planets, and galactic center. So that as we breathe along this column of white light, this white fire, from earth to heaven, heaven to earth. And let's draw that energy in and towards the lower dantian, folding one hand over the other. Imagining, if you will, as if those logong points in the center of the palms of your hands were to open in abundance. Of energy and chi flowing into the reservoir within, recharging. And allow yourself to fill. Fill to overflowing, so that the overflowing abundance spills to the earth around you, nourishing and giving life. Maintaining this sense of connectivity, let's just relax the legs and shake out the arms for a moment. Let's go ahead and get back into shoulder width apart. Then we open up, bringing our arms into a T position. Taking a nice deep breath in, turning the palms out. Connecting that thread around the entire planet. Then we breathe out, exhaling, swinging the energy across and back arm counterbalance. Breathing back into center, connect, exhale across. Again, imagining when you come back to center, seeing as you breathe into the heart, breathe into the lungs, opening the palms out and away, seeing that ray of light and chi stretching out across, rounding the entire planet. Let's bring it back to center. Hands come and find that little ball energy in front of the lower dantian again. The Again, I'll be your mirror, so we're gonna shift our weight into our left, turn out to the right, bringing the ball of energy with us. Inner reverse flowing, drawing the energy up to the heart, exhaling, pushing away. Breathing in, drawing the energy back into the heart, exhaling down through hollow empty legs into the earth. Breathing in, up to the heart, exhaling, pushing away. Once again, an invitation to help with focus.
Find a place on the deck
that your eye can return to, or a place on the horizon, a leaf, a stick, part of a tree, part of a house that your eye can return to each time.
So it's almost as if you were breathing in and out your energy from that one point in the universe.
And you're drawing that line to that one point in the universe with your hands. The hands, the movement, the intention, the breath all sync up, focus, quiet.
Let's do one more from wherever you are.
Bring the ball of energy down by the right hip again, shifting back into the left. We're going to bring the ball back to center, shift into the right, lifting up the energy from the left hip, exhaling, pressing away. Inhaling to the heart, exhaling down towards the earth. Inhaling, drawing up from the earth, exhaling away. Find that point on the horizon. From that point on the deck or on the earth, where your eye can focus and your breath can draw all the energy from that one point. Inner rivers flowing. Let's do one more all the way through from wherever you are. Bringing that ball of energy up by the left hip again. Turning back to center, gather and release off and to the right, lifting almost as if you're releasing a dove. Soft lady's fingers, like you're tracing a waterfall down by the right hip. Gathering some more water, gathering another dove, releasing off and to the left. Gathering with your breath as you lift, exhaling as you release, finding the rhythm, the sync up, the breath and the movement. Again, what do we spend our time gathering? Can we release it so that we can make room to gather that which is most important? Let's do one more to each side, from wherever you are. Crossing the arms in front of the heart, in front of the chest, tight fists, embracing tiger, opening from tiger, scooping down deep into the earth, gathering the energy of the earth, lifting it towards the heavens in a great column, opening to the heavens, and then we gather the energy from the heavens down into the earth. Breathing in as we lift, exhaling, making room, gathering our breath as we draw it down to the earth. Let's bring the hands back down by the hips into loose fists, soft, settling down, feeling that almost as if your coccyx or your tailbone would connect down to the earth again. You're in a strong trine. You soften the right hand, lifting up in front of the right shoulder. And we drift across the horizon, the eyes focused on the palms of the hands. And then back to the center, reaching towards the center, drawing in. Then we open the left in front of the right shoulder, arcing across the horizon, eyes focused on the center of the palms of the hand. Back to center. Drawing within, softening the right, breathing in as we lift, exhaling slowly across the horizon, inhaling back to center, exhaling as we draw within, balance, exhaling. And this one is called Calm at the Center of the Storm. All the storms that are mixing and churning around. Can we find the quiet at the eye of the storm so that we can focus and cultivate that which is most important, so that we can polish and refine and draw a fine crystal, diamond, jewel within. Let's do one more to each side, and on this last one, closing the fingers up so that those thousands of things that would distract us can just be released. That we may focus on the one, polished, refined. Opening the palms of the hands, lifting up the hands to prayer hands, return to mountain. From the mountain, we step to the peak. We find the sanctum and we gently part the veil, reaching around, behind, within, finding one of those gems that we've polished, offering that from the heart to the guardians, the keeper, bowing in respect. Stretching to the heavens, almost as if we have a rope for a giant bell, and we draw that down, ringing in jubilee to the earth, and from the earth back to the heavens, return to mountain, pause for a moment, breathe, relax, notice. And let's step yet closer to the inner sanctum as we stretch forward again. Parting the veil, gently reaching behind, within, drawing a gem from our satchel of that inner quiet from the center of the storm, bowing to the keeper in gratitude. Stretching to the heavens, ringing in jubilee. Return to mountain. And pausing for a moment here as you breathe in and out, noticing. Feeling that channel of white light that goes from the center of the core of the earth all the way up through galactic center, through your body temple. With each breath, feeling, releasing. That as we step into the inner sanctum, we don't come to ask, we come to merge. So we stretch forward one last time, reaching into the inner sanctum, drawing that last veil open, around, behind, within, finding that gem that was truly worth polishing. Bowing to the guardian, stretching to the heavens, and ring that bell in jubilee. Return to mountain. And this time we open out soft hands, smoothing, drawing the energy up from the earth, up past the heart, and as we do so, pressing up to the heavens, forming that little mudra with the index finger and the thumbs, allowing the eyes to relax in the space in between. Allowing yourself to sit a little bit deeper into your legs, again allowing your tailbone in your consciousness to almost stretch down to the earth, like you were sitting on a tripod. And let's press against the envelope of the heavens, golden dome sweeping the edges, drawing in the breath, drawing in the stars. Exhaling, pushing away, little mudras, allowing the eyes to relax in the space between. And one more time, pressing against the heavens, sweeping the earth, drawing the breath up, exhaling, turning, mudras, eyes relaxed in the space between. And then let's press against the heavens. And this time let's sweep it down and through, anchoring, grounding the energy through the central column. Gathering the breath, sweeping up, palms to the heavens. Allowing the energy to draw down, grounding. And as you do this, breathing in and out in rhythm that makes sense to you. Perhaps it's breathing in as you lift and exhaling as you press. And as you're doing this, I invite you to draw in your awareness, draw in those extensions of your consciousness from your branches, from the stars and galactic center, and the top of the canopy of the tree. Draw in those branches back down into the top of the crown. And same thing with your roots. Draw in your awareness of your consciousness from the center of the core of the earth, back up through stone, crystalline underground caverns, underground slow-moving water, cool, moist earth, until the roots reconnect back in with the bottoms of your feet. And on the next breath in, we're going to shift our weight over into the left, bringing the right foot back in, sweeping the heavens one more time, return to mountain prayer, hands at the heart. And from prayer hands, we extend out, opening our table of bounty, gratitude that we may nourish our communities and our families, the energy that we've gathered here. And I say thank you.